Welcome back to Glendale, Arizona. Kings and Coyotes. The Coyotes already have one win on the season. The Kings, of course, looking for their first of the year. Captain Dustin Brown, big focus coming into this game. Of course, we just documented both in the pregame and our open what would be expected tonight. Everyone's waiting to see that. Shane Doan. But in the back of everyone's mind, Bob, it's there. But again, at the same time, Kings desperately need a win right now. So you take that over anything else. Of course, if the other stuff comes, you take that too. Andre Kopitar looked like he was just getting, he's just a sliver away. Had that shot in the post the other night in Edmonton to get things going. Derek Morris, one of the veteran defensemen. Officials tonight, Tim Peel, along with Francois Saint-Laurent. On the lines, Pierre Grassico and Mark Šuček. Right now, play-by-play, Bob Miller.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. And we are underway here in Glendale, Arizona, as the Coyotes have it back in their own zone and bring it up to center ice. Kings take it away. The Kings start out with Carter and Richards and Clifford on the forward line as the puck sent in deep by Kyle Clifford, the Kings' leading scorer with 4 points on the year, points in three straight games. And offside, Sullivan tried to hold up there at the blue line but couldn't quite do it.
We saw it last game, Bob, with Kyle Clifford moving up onto the line with Mike Richards and Jeff Carter. Now, Kyle Clifford starts the season on the fourth line. That's his role. He's proving that he can play with higher pace and play up there at the same time. A player like Mike Richards does not need other players to make him better. Mike Richards, as a veteran, as a creator out there, he's the type of guy that makes someone else play a better game. So he has to pick it up, again, be a little bit more creative.
Now the Kings with Kopitar out along with Brown. Right side for Bukowski, cutting in front, poked away by Jonathan Quick, and the Kings go for it again down in their own zone. Dustin Brown on the ice. It's his 599th career NHL game tonight and 272nd consecutive game for the King captain. Kings clear it up to center ice. Justin Williams goes for there, gets help from Kopitar. Puck taken away, right side again for Bukowski. Couldn't get a good shot, it was just poked away as he went to shoot. And the puck not cleared out yet by Martinez.
That was Dustin Brown once again, Bob. Remember a couple games we talked with Dustin. He said, you know, he played in Europe, less stopping and starting, more circling right there. Stop and start, working on the back check.
That was knocked away by Jason LaBarbera, who's in goal, the former King goaltender. Mike Smith, who had such a great year last year for the Coyotes, is out with a lower body injury, but they're not making too many doubts about that it's a groin injury and he may be out for a while. This is scooped up here by Jonathan Quick.
Well, that leads us, Bob, right to our Staples matchup in goal. We talked about Jonathan Quick in the pregame show, and he feels better. He feels like he's more comfortable on the road. He gets a chance to concentrate and focus a little bit more. Of course, LaBarbera, he's been a backup here for a little while now, and that's what he's set into, so called upon right now because of the injury.
Martin Hanzel out for the Coyotes. He was a little questionable before the game. He's been banged up a little bit, but he wins the draw. Shot is high and wide to the right as the Kings try to pick up the loose puck, and they do. Settle on the boards, but not chipped out yet. Now it's flipped out to center ice by Dwight King. Coyotes come back to take it away. Game just underway here in Glendale, Arizona. No score yet. Coyotes with it. Here's Radim Vrbata on the right side. Up the middle, a shot wide to the right side by Hanzel. Right in the slot, but he shot it wide and the puck taken by the Kings. Back they come to center ice now. Trevor Lewis, right in front of the Coyote bench, chopped away from him.
Well, the second time on that chip off, Hanzel doing a great job for the Coyotes, so he's banged up a little bit, but it's not showing here early. On top of his game and breaking up plays.
Jordan Nolan for the Kings tried to send it up the right side to Simon Gagné. Gagné on the ice in this game tonight, and an icing call here against the Kings.
And Simon Gagné, part of a theme that Daryl Sutter was talking about this morning at the morning skate. It's not what you have done or what you might do, it's what you're doing right now. So Simon Gagné sat out a couple of games. He was flying the other day in practice in Edmonton, so we'll see if he's on his game here. Starts on the fourth line, of course, he could move up.
Colin Fraser on the draw for the Kings, but it's held in. Derek Morris sends it down in deep toward the back of the King net. Kings going for there. The Kings 0-2-1 so far on the season, looking for win number one tonight. Here along the boards, and Chipchura didn't get it, but it comes to the blue line, and a glove save by Quick, and then a pileup as a Coyote slides into another Coyote down there in front of the net. Nick Johnson, they got him from Minnesota. He got knocked down.
Right there, Bob, an example of how a simple wrist shot from the point by Keith Yandle can become a dangerous type of play, because you get bodies skating back and forth. You get him just screening the goaltender, take away the eyes, you see what happens after there. And it was a simple wrist shot by Keith Yandle, but he sensed that traffic, tried to get it down low.
Rob Scuderi on the ice for the Kings defensively. He said about this situation, to regain composure. It's okay to be desperate, but it's not okay to panic. And I don't think there is any panic by the Kings right now. Long pass in, down the middle, a backhander and a save on Antoine Vermette.
And we're going to see contact with a goaltender. And the faceoff's going to come outside. I think this is an incidental contact situation, where the momentum of the player trying to make an offensive move, there's contact. See the referee on the left side, blows it right down. Nothing's going to happen after this. He's not going to give a penalty to Vermette because, he's kind of spun around. But because of that, I like that type of play right there, because it prevents any type of goal being scored after contact. Don't necessarily like to stop it. You want to keep the game going. But I think a good read by a referee, especially early in the game, trying to send a message.
Dustin Brown flips it in, but an offside called here. And Brown getting a few round of boos from the crowd.
What to watch for tonight, I talked about it, centers of attention. Daryl Sutter, part of his leadership philosophy is to put a lot of pressure on centermen. Power play, can they get it working? Everyone's going to watch that right now at the beginning of the season. The Coyotes, they have players on the lineup. Mike Smith's not in goal. Are they going to lock it down? I just mentioned a couple seconds ago, they've scored 15 goals in four games, but they're not happy with their game because offense is not their identity. It's more about shutting it down.
Kings drive it in as Voinov sends it into the Phoenix zone. Boy, the last time these two teams met here, this building was rocking. It was jammed. Not quite tonight. A lot of empty seats so far here tonight.
Once again, Bob, there was a couple of fans in the stands. We were set up to do our post game. They were quite happy with us. Or maybe me.
Yeah, I think you you were not holding back, let's say that.
Well, I wasn't in the press box, so I didn't have to worry about, the cheering parts.
That's right. Martin Hanzel drops it back, and a shot deflected wide to the left side. Michael Bodker with a shot. Hanzel gets the rebound. His pass. Bodker goes to the front of the net. He tried to turn around and deflect the shot. Couldn't do it. Then a shot from the right side is up high and over the net by Korpikoski, and the Kings pick it up back in their own zone. Puck taken by Alec Martinez now for the Kings. No score here in the first period. Bob Miller along with Jim Fox. Patrick O'Neill with us again tonight. And the pass up ahead to Kyle Clifford. Clifford across the line. Clifford turns, fires a pass in toward Richards. Richards gets checked there. Wrapped around, is intercepted, and the Kings try to hold it in. They do from the blue line. A shot wide to the right side. And back it comes over to Jeff Carter. The shot is by Drewski. Coach Daryl Sutter saying this morning, Drewski has to fill in for Matt Green until the Kings are able to get Matt Green back.
Of course, Matt Green, a right-hand shot. That's one thing the Kings were very happy with last year, the righty-lefty. You have Drewski, a left-hand guy, playing on the right side.
Clifford driving back behind the net. Still has it on his stick. Puts it down in the corner. Now the Kings keep the pressure on. Here is Carter back to the blue line. Tried to give it to Muzzin. Jake Muzzin, the rookie defenseman. His pass taken by Derek Morris, but he got checked by Clifford. Now Colin Fraser gives it to Clifford. Back to the blue line. Kings with it. Shot from there. Just chipped wide in front of his Colin Fraser. Into the corner. Puck taken away now by Boyd Gordon. Gordon up to center ice for the Coyotes, and he flips it down in deep. Back behind the net. Taken there by the Kings again. And here's Drew Doughty getting a lot of minutes on the ice here early in the season.
Good sign the last couple of shifts for the Kings. Get that cycle going that they worked last year. That allows you, with the Kings' size, to wear down the opposition by the end of the game.
Coyotes drive it into the Kings' zone. Rob Scuderi back to get it. Over to Doughty. His pass around the boards to Nolan. Nolan gets stopped there. Puck is picked up by Nick Johnson. Johnson's pass is going to be taken away by the Kings, but he gets it right back again and gets knocked down by Scuderi, and the loose puck taken by Colin Fraser. Pass up in the air and deflected back into the King zone again and chased down by Nick Johnson. Johnson wraparound, saved by Quick, and a penalty coming up on the play for hooking.
Nick Johnson very quick there to take the puck on one side, try the wrap on the other. If you think Jonathan Quick has any rustiness in him, it's gone. Because watch this move. Great, watch him go across. Bang, one move, one step, pad there, and Quick was there well before Johnson got to the other side. But what will happen? Stick it in the midsection right there, almost a corkscrew by Drew Doughty. and he'll end up going to the penalty box, so the speed on the outside hurts the Kings. Coyotes get the first chance, man, advantage.
Nick Johnson had 77 games in Minnesota last year with 8 goals and 18 assists, signed as a free agent by Phoenix this summer. So the power play now for Phoenix. They are 5 of 19 on the year, 26.3. There's a shot up high and over the net. 11th best here in the early going on the power play for Phoenix. The King penalty killing is 10th best here in the early part of the season. And the Coyotes back up to center with a chance to get the first goal of this game with the man advantage offside as Coyote got knocked down in the zone and Sullivan brought it across the line.
Well, Dave Tippett is the head coach, of course, of the Phoenix Coyotes. And during the lockout, his wife, Wendy, called him Mr. Grumpy Optimistic. How are those two going together? He said, well, you know what? He was always optimistic we would play again. And, of course, he's right. But he was grumpy that they weren't playing. So Dave Tippett, of course, Bob, known as that guy who builds that feeling around the team because they don't always have the most talented roster, but us against the world. And it's worked here in Phoenix.
Penalty killers defensively for the Kings, Drewski and Scuderi. Up front, the Kings have Carter and Richards. Puck fired deep into the Kings zone now. On the power play for the Coyotes, Shane Doan put it in deep, but the Kings took it away and it's cleared off the boards. Back down with 1 minute left to go now in the King penalty.
We just saw it there on the last one. It was Drewski out there with Scuderi. Of course, Doughty's in the penalty box at the same time. If Drewski's going to take over for Matt Green, he's going to see a lot of time on the penalty kill.
Here's Martin Hensel with it now for the Coyotes. His pass taken away and cleared up the center ice and down deep where LaBarbera plays it there. And Coyotes regroup back in their own zone. 12:55 to go here in the first period. Kings are home Monday night against the Vancouver Canucks. We'll tell you more about that. Everybody going to get a gift when they come in on Monday night. Puck is along the boards to Radim Verbata. Now to the right point, Derek Morris. He shoots, save, rebound sent wide by Hensel.
Everyone gets a gift. That is a good ring to it.
There's a little hint for you. Puck held in now by Radim Verbata. Verbata back to the blue line. Coyotes still with a man advantage. Verbata again. He shoots, save, rebound. Hensel, pass in front and just underneath the stick of Vermette. He had an open corner of the net, but couldn't get his stick on it. Coyotes keep the pressure on. Kings trying to clear. They can't do it. Michael Bodker. Bodker's pass. Kings are back at full strength. Pass up the middle. Saved by Quick on the shot by Hensel. Again, the Coyotes. Yandel up the middle. Kings are back at full strength, but the Coyotes still with the puck in the Kings zone. Keith Yandel down the left side. Yandel along the boards. He gets checked there, and the puck poked out to center ice by Slava Voynov. Quickly back on the Coyotes. Keith Yandel, right point. Yandel shoots. It's blocked and cleared up to center ice. Chased across the line by Justin Williams. Picked up now by Zbigniew McCulloch. They got him in the offseason from Pittsburgh.
They needed to pick someone else up. Roosevelt leaves to go elsewhere. You need a guy, same type of player. Eats up a lot of minutes.
Coyotes again. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, good-looking young defenseman. He sends it into the King zone, and the puck taken away by the Kings, and here's Justin Williams. Williams flips it down in deep into the Coyote zone. McCulloch checked there by Kopitar. Kopitar trying to get the puck in the corner. He did. Then a shot saved by LaBarbera. Shot from the right. Then another glove save on the shot by Muzzin. So we're scoreless with some pretty good goaltending here early in the game at both ends of the ice. There's a save by Quick. We'll be right back.
Hey, welcome back. I'm Patrick O'Neill. No score, Kings and Coyotes. Tonight's Coors Light cold hard fact is this. The Kings are not going to pass on a shot of whiskey. You heard Bob and Jim talking about Davis Drewski replacing Matt Green. You see his time on ice. Only 9 games last year. I talked to Davis today. He would never tell you he was frustrated last year, but he was. Now he doesn't have to worry about him being in or out. Most important thing for him is the penalty kill. It takes a lot of pride in that. Bob and Jim, back to you.
All right, Patrick, thank you very much as the Kings Kopitar put it behind the net to Justin Williams, Phoenix zone. Here's Williams with it, down to one knee. Trying to give it back over to Kopitar. He kind of got spun around, and Williams over to try and dig it out. He did for a moment, but Boyd Gordon got it. Now the Kings get it back again. Williams in the corner to Kopitar. Kopitar's pass up the middle to Brown. Brown back to Williams. Justin Williams on the right side. Williams back to the right point. Sent it down along the boards to Kopitar. Now to the blue line. Shot by Muzzin. Saved. Rebound in front. Tipped away. Again, Jake Muzzin. His shot deflected wide to the right side and taken by Kopitar.
Once again, strong forecheck by the Kings. Maybe the start of this first period, more sustained pressure on forechecks than any other game. I know the other night the Kings had a lot of pressure in the first because they were on a 5-on-3 and a lot of power play opportunities. We're right here, 5-on-5, pretty good by the Kings.
Now back up to center ice. Talking about that power play that the Kings have not had one yet tonight. Here on the right side is a shot deflected up in the air. That shot by Kyle Chipchura. And it bounces to center and chased down by Clifford. But Morris has the angle on him and gives it over to Chipchura. Now back up to center ice come the Coyotes with no score here in the first period. Alexander Buldich drives it down into the King zone, down in the corner, tipped away behind the net, taken by Scuderi, but he lost his stick, so he shovels it over to Carter, who gets it out to center ice.
We saw it the other night in Edmonton. Make sure you can shovel it. You can never even cover the puck.
Right.
You've got to keep your hand away from the top of the puck, otherwise you go into the box.
Now, there's no more closing your hand on the puck. It's just putting your hand on the puck and passing it. You'll get called for it. Pass to the King line, knocked down there by Slava Voynov. He gives it to Gagne. Simone Gagne, right wing, up the middle. Nolan with a shot, knocked down to the left of the net by LaBarbera. Jordan Nolan with a shot from right in the slot. And the puck is going to be taken by the Coyotes and cleared out the center. Everybody spinning around like a revolving door there for a moment to try and get it. This one is caught by LaBarbera. And he hangs on to it for a faceoff. 8:56 to go here in the first period. We're going to get penalties here as we go to break. There's no score. We'll be right back.
Well, guess what? It looks like the Kings are going on a 5-on-3. Not only Yandle, but you see 53, Morris in the box. We didn't pick anything up with 53. You see down left side, watch this. Slash and punch. Bang, right there. So Yandle gets a two-minute minder. Morris also picks ones up, so I would have to assume that it happened earlier on that shift. We still do not have the official call on the play, but Dave Tippett and his team, pretty good start. They've had the first power play. They've had some pretty good pressure, pretty good pace, and he's just giving it to the ref right now, the back ref. That is Tim Peel. And there's Colin Frazier. He loves the job he did right there. Stir it up and send the other guys to the box.
Well, the Kings with a two-man advantage for a full 2 minutes. We've seen this before, and the Kings 0-2 with a two-man advantage so far this season.
Yandle, unsportsmanlike contact for Morris. So that's he must have said something along the way to the penalty box. Something going on, too much. 5-on-3.
Great opportunity again for the Kings here. Richards gives it to Kopitar. Kopitar back to Doughty. Doughty to Kopitar. Kopitar to Doughty. One-timer knocked down in front. Brown was skating right through in front of LaBarbera.
Broken stick for one of the Coyotes.
Pass on the right wing side. Kings with it. Here is Richards to Kopitar. Kopitar shoots and a save and a rebound to Doughty.
Right now it's the forward that doesn't have the stick, so easier passes.
Doughty, his shot blocked. Not clear. Held in by Kopitar. Kopitar to Doughty, to Kopitar. Top of the slot, right side, cross ice now. Kopitar shoots and a save, LaBarbera. And the rebound held in by the Kings again. Kopitar gives it over to Doughty. Doughty in the circle to Kopitar. One-timer saved by LaBarbera again. Picked up by Richards. Richards, pass across, picked up now by the Kings. They hold it in, left side. Taken there by Carter to Doughty, to Kopitar, to Doughty. Doughty waits, gives it to Kopitar. Kopitar shoots, blocked in front. Loose puck, picked up by Richards. Richards with it. Kings still with a two-man advantage. Picked up by Brown. Here's Dustin Brown, left side. He feeds it back now to Doughty. Doughty over to Kopitar. Kopitar hanging on to Richards. In front to Carter, and a save by LaBarbera.
Well, the Kings took advantage of Boyd Gordon at the top. He didn't have a stick. So they made three or four passes right by him, and understandably, he couldn't get anything on it to block the passes. But once it got down low, the Coyotes were exceptional at making sure no second chances. And the Kings never really got a clear shot through. I mean, a hard shot through at the end. You see Richards trying that play, kind of that low percentage play down low. Both defensemen down low had the stick, so nothing yet. 5-on-3.
39 seconds to go in the two-man advantage. Here's Doughty. Phoenix zone. Doughty feeds it up the middle. Gets it back. One-timer. That was blocked down into the corner by Stone. Picked up back behind the net now. Kings go for it. Taken away by the Coyotes. Can they clear? Not yet. Kings hold it in. Doughty put it down into the corner. He gets it back again. Here's Doughty. Doughty's pass, right side shot from there. Knocked down and a rebound left side. Doughty holds it in again. Now to the blue line and out to center ice. Martinez back to get it. 6 seconds to go in the two-man advantage. Here's Williams up the middle to Doughty. Doughty, his shot is wide. And the power play is over, and the Kings again fail for the third time this year with a two-man advantage. And the puck is not cleared, held in by Doughty. Doughty shoots, deflected into the corner. Coyotes try to clear, can't do it. Martinez holds it in. Left side, here's Dwight King. King moving in, pass in front, and a save, LaBarbera on Williams.
Good pop. Two of those five-on-threes for the Kings have been with complete full 2 minutes on five-on-threes. Now, a little bit more urgency you saw right there, five-on-three. You saw it happening as far as down low and movement and shots getting through, but no second opportunities. And right there at the end, well, if that would have gone in, that would have been a backbreaker because all that time on a five-on-three, you don't get anything to show for it. And that time, Dwight King was just looking for something to happen in front, so a different approach by the Kings. They were more aggressive trying to get shots, but nothing dangerous getting through.
So the Kings 0 for 2 on the power play. They are now 0 for 21 on the season. And off the draw here, the Coyotes move it up ahead to the blue line. Now center ice. No score in the first period. Kings let a golden opportunity get away again.
How important is this one right here? After killing a 5-on-3, we'll see if the Coyotes build momentum. We'll see if the Kings can kind of settle it back down.
Puck along the boards to the blue line to Morris. He holds it right on the line. Gets it left side. A shot just wide to the left side. And puck is taken by the Kings, and they get it up the left wing to Simon Gagné. Gagné flips it up in the air. Coyotes back in their own zone now with 6 minutes left to go in the first period. Coyotes come to center. Morris, long shot, high and wide to the left. Bodker goes for it. Bodker out of Denmark. And it's held in. Now along the boards. It is not cleared yet. Coyotes still keep it alive. Now the Kings take it away. They get it to Nolan. Jordan Nolan to center ice, and he flips it off the boards. The Kings want to get a line change. Shots are even at 8 apiece. Coyotes back up to center ice now. 1-3 on the season for the Coyotes. Kings take it in their own zone. Here's Doughty, his pass. Going to be intercepted for a moment. Now taken by Antoine Vermette. Vermette for the Coyotes behind the net. Trying to give it to Sullivan. Sullivan had a hat trick in their last game. And the puck picked up by Vermette. Vermette had a great chance early in the game. And his pass to the blue line gets out to center ice. Shot right back in. And Jonathan Quick will shovel it off on the right side. The Kings get it to Mike Richards. Richards up ahead to center to Clifford. Kyle Clifford drives it in. Not one Kings center has a goal yet this year. Puck picked up by the Coyotes, and back they come to center with under 5 minutes to go in the first. Puck sent down behind the net. The Kings take over again. Cleared to the blue line and jumped out to center ice. Every time Brown touches the puck now, the crowd getting on him because of that hit on Michael Roosevelt in game 5 of the Western Conference Final playoff series last year. And again, Brown shovels it down in deep into the Coyote zone. Kings take it away. A shot knocked off the pads of LaBarbera from a sharp angle by Williams on the right side. Coyotes go for it. They get it up to center ice and down into the Kings zone. And an icing call against Phoenix coming up here.
And a reminder to the Kings fans, get your tickets now to see the Kings take on the Canucks Monday, January 28th. That's coming up, 7:30 p.m. Every fan will take home an LA Kings replica championship ring presented by Fox Sports West. Very, very few tickets remain. Visit LAKings.com/tickets to secure your seat and to get your ring.
Face off in the Coyote zone, and the puck to the blue line and out to center ice.
Back to that booing bob of Dustin Brown. Did anyone here see the flash of Mike Smith? On? I'm just wondering.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay.
The referee saw it, too, and he thought Brown embellished it.
Diver.
Explain that one to me. And tipped away and back up to center ice now. Dwight King moves it off on the right side and flipped down in deep. King going for it down in the corner along with Derek Morris. Taken away by the Coyotes and back they come to center. Kings were changing on the fly. Puck back the right side. Taken there and sent along the board by Chipchura. Faced in by Alexander Bolduc. Knocked away from him and Dwight King with it. King's pass taken by the Kings and cleared up ahead to Nolan at center ice. Jordan Nolan crossed the line and Coyotes take it away with 3:19 to go in the first period. Kings chase it down. Here's Slava Voynov. He got it up the center ice. Nolan again. Pack hands it up in the air, and the Coyotes take over. Clear it off the boards to the blue line, and then cleared out to center ice by Nick Johnson. Kings back to take it. Here's Simone Gagné. Gagné shoots from just inside the blue line, but is blocked, and the Coyotes turn it back the other way. Back down the right wing side, Martin Hanzel. Hanzel's pass taken away by Gagné, who cleared it out to center.
Gagné did not see that Colin Frazier was tired and had to make a change, so when he made the pass, Frazier was turning the other way.
Now the Kings with it, and Carter came to the blue line, but Coyotes have it now back at center ice into the Kings zone. Left side, chased down in deep, and a shot from a sharp angle is knocked down. Hodker with that shot, and the Kings start back out again as Drewiski brings it up the center. Carter couldn't handle it. Here's Hanzel across the line.
Too many men on the ice once again for the LA Kings. That's the third time in two games. So one little penalty, we'll see if it hurts the Kings. The Kings miss on the 5-on-3. Coyotes coming back, man. Dwight King will serve the too many men on the ice penalty, even though he was not involved in the play. Keep an eye on the right side of your screen as we move it forward. Jake Muzzin is going to come onto the ice. Stop right there. There's Muzzin on the ice. You see number 7, Rob Scuderi? He has to be within 5 feet of the bench. Nothing goes wrong. It happens right where the referee is, and he sees the player coming on involved in the play. And that's the obvious call. 5-on-4 power play, Coyotes.
And Vermette wins the draw. The puck comes back on the right side on the power play. The Coyotes now, they're 0-for-1 with 3 shots the last time they had the man advantage. And the Kings take it away and clear it. Vermette is their top faceoff man. 60.6% of the draws he wins. And the Coyotes back to center ice. Sullivan had it poke checked away. The hat trick he had recently was against Columbus, the 8th of his career.
Nice stick there by Stoll in the neutral zone. Sullivan has some pretty good speed, some nifty moves, but the stick takes away the time and space.
Back up to center ice now, and across the line, the Coyotes into the King zone. Here's Shane Doan. Doan on the right side, but his pass comes back out to center ice, and the Coyotes regroup again with a minute 30 left to go here in the first period.
They keep telling Shane, don't pass it like that.
Into this period, Patrick O'Neill will talk with one of the Kings. Back up to center ice. Driven down into the King zone. It comes around to Drewiski in the corner. He gets checked there. Drewiski gets it up on the right side to Colin Frazier, and he clears it the rest of the way.
So real good pressure, smart pressure this time by the Kings on the penalty kill, and no setup time whatsoever so far by the Coyotes.
Kings have allowed 3 power play goals to this point in 19 times short. Back up to center ice with less than a minute to go in the period. Morris drives it into the Kings zone. Comes around off the board. Stopped right to the side of the net. Kings don't clear it. Morris at the right point. He gets it down now to Radim Verbata. Now back to Morris at the right point. Morris hangs on. Feeds it over on the left side. Return to Morris. Morris shoots. Deflected. And a face-off coming up, I think, out. No?
They're trying to figure it out, Bob. That's the referees. The line's been getting together. Much like the other night in Edmonton, when the goal was waved off against the Oilers, I did get an email from the NHL where they said this is something that was instituted by the general managers last season. They do want referees and linesmen to confer after there's any doubt about contact in the crease. That's what happened the other night in Edmonton. They got it right. Disallowed the goal.
Faceoff stays in the Kings zone, but the Kings win the draw, and it is cleared back into the Coyote zone with 22 seconds left to go in the first period. No score in the game. Coyotes still on the power play for 2 more seconds. They come to center, and the Kings now are back at full strength. Coyotes in the Kings zone. Out of the penalty box, the puck comes around the boards on the right side. King was serving the penalty bench minor to the Kings for too many men. King intercepts this centering pass, but now Korpakowski with a shot and a save by Quick. And that is the end of the first period. Shots are even at 9 apiece, but boy, another golden opportunity for the Kings is not taken advantage of.
Yeah, I thought the Kings were real good on the forecheck for the first 10 minutes. They really had a wear-down cycle game going. Got away from that because the Coyotes became more efficient getting the puck out of the zone, but bottom line, a little different look with Kopitar in the middle on the 5-on-3, but still the Kings not getting their dangerous players, getting dangerous shots on goal with a 2-man advantage.
Andre Kopitar, the King, still playing with that knee brace. He may have to have it on for the remainder of this shortened season. But we're at the end of one period with no score in the game. The Kings and the Coyotes at the end of one. Coming up, Patrick with a King right after this.
I saw him at 3 half-yard beers last night, so they're going to change the name for that. Jonathan Quick gets ready to start this game, this period. He was busy there, but he made some pretty good stops. He looked flexible, he looked quick, all the things you worry about with a back injury. Jordan Nolan, 3 hits to lead the Kings in the first period once again. So we saw it in Edmonton the other night, probably more than the other game. And the ability to make those hits without being reckless and keeping the shoulder, arm, everything down so you don't take a penalty.
Jason LaBarbera, the former King, is in goal because Mike Smith is out with an injury for the Coyotes. And LaBarbera entering tonight, 1 win, 2 losses in his career when he faces the Kings. There we have Doan along with Kyle Clifford.
Those guys looking to get locked up. We'll see. I would assume Kyle Clifford's one of those players, Bob, that would look up to a player like Shane Doan over the years. Kyle a lot younger. And I'm sure Kyle would want to progress and get to be the type of player Shane has been throughout his career. And so far this season, Kyle's doing a pretty good job.
Yeah. Well, a lot of guys would like to be the kind of player Shane Doan is. Tonight is his 1,203rd game in the NHL. Long shot and a save there on the shot by Doan. A rebound shot by Doan is wide. He spent all those games with this franchise in Winnipeg and then here in Phoenix. Puck is taken by the Kings and Carter comes to center ice. He got it from Clifford. Here's Carter, but his shot is partially blocked and the Coyotes turn it back the other way. Second period just underway here in Glendale, Arizona. Drewski sends it around the boards and then gets a return pass. And here's Drewski up to center ice. Nice pass to the blue line taken by Kopitar. And a shot by Brown and a save. And hanging on is Jason LaBarbera.
No, we were just talking about Kyle Clifford. So effective this year. Moving up the line, getting a promotion. You go back to Staples Center against the Hawks. The buzzing fourth line getting it done, and Kyle Clifford will find his way somehow to the front of the net and just be involved. And that's one thing you want to do, keep it alive, and when you have the chance, put it home.
Now the Kings in front. Kopitar shoots. He scores! Kopitar right in front of the net, and the Kings have a 1-0 lead.
I got the feeling the other night, Bob, Kopitar was just that close. Well, now he is not that close anymore. He was perfect. Now the setup for the Coyotes is a breakdown because Kopitar is the most dangerous player on the ice, takes the faceoff, he ends up losing the draw. Look at that pressure though immediately. That immediate pressure by Williams and Kopitar backs off. Gordon, the centerman, did not stay with Kopitar. The rule of thumb is center, stay with center. Watch Kopitar lean and back. That's an NHL goal because that's how you score nowadays on NHL goaltenders. Under the blocker, over the pad. But good use of body motion by Kopitar to lean one way and throw it back to the other.
So the first goal of the year for Andre Kopitar, and the Kings have a 1-0 lead. 1:04, the time of the goal here in this period. They only give Brown, I think Williams thought he had a stick on it down in the corner and gave it to Brown.
He certainly made it happen. Williams, you see there on the right, that jump factor. The best player ever I've seen at that has been Dave Taylor, where you're in an offensive zone faceoff. You lose the draw, but who gets the puck? Your team, because Williams was the first man there, creating some pressure and forcing the turnover. Again, the breakdown, Gordon not staying with Kopitar, and Kopitar makes you pay. What a wrist shot. Hold, kind of freeze the goaltender, then let it go.
Faceoff down to the right of Jonathan Quick. Don't drop the puck yet. Jared Stoll on the draw, and he wins the faceoff for the Kings. Puck taken up to center ice now, and Trevor Lewis down the right side, in toward Dwight King. King checked there by Michael Stone, and King comes out with a puck in the corner. King walks in front, he shoots, and a save by LaBarbera in the glove.
So the Kings get that first man pressure again. That's creating problems for the Coyotes. And the Coyotes upset with their last game, had a 2-goal lead in the third, lost it because the Sharks really turned it on. You see the first man pressure, but then Stoll comes in, support factor. Now it's not necessarily a quality chance because comes from the angle, but that's kind of the play I was talking about, Bob, in the first intermission, where the Kings' forecheck was pretty effective for the first 10 minutes of the first period. It's a pretty good start here in the second.
So the only assist on the goal by Kopitar is to Brown. Williams took a swipe at it, did not get his stick on it. Puck taken by Alexander Bolduken, tips it down deep in the King zone, and here's Drewinski back to get it. Now picked up by Yandel. Yandel gets stopped with a pass up the middle, just out of the reach there, and a penalty coming up against the Kings. A delayed call. The Kings try to get to the puck. They don't get there yet, and now they do, and holding the stick is going to be the call.
So the Kings had to scramble a little bit right there. Now you have two referees talking to each other. We had multiple penalties earlier against the Coyotes. One was, though, an unsportsmanlike conduct where we assumed Derek Morris had some words for the referee. Keith Yandel is, you see him right there, he's going over to talk, or at least to be around. St. Laurent was the back referee. I think Peel 20 was the front referee. And only one man is going to the box right now, and that is Jake Muzzin. So holding the stick is the call. I think maybe the Coyotes asking, Bob, why the whistle went, and, you know, you have to have complete control of the puck nowadays before they blow it down. We'll see the end of it. I think in behind everyone here, I think Colin Frazier ends up with a puck on his stick with control. It's right there, right there, right there. Yes, he does take a stick handle with it, and he shovels it along the boards. So for that reason, the referee felt. Now, the referees are still huddling. Interesting. Well, let's not be surprised if something else develops here, because we have one linesman and two referees together. Right now, only Muzzin's penalty's on the board. So, sorting things out, you see Tim Peel turn around and says, okay, I'm going to do something else here, maybe. Just on edge because, of course, you have Muzzin already in the box. And you don't want to have. Now, both referees go to each bench for full explanations to the coaches. And the door is open to the Kings' penalty box, and that's what I was done. There it is. I was worried about the something else coming, and it has come. It's come down on the Kings. Frazier's now talking with a referee. And it looks like Cullen's going to be the guy going to the box. So 5-on-3. It happened in the first period the other way around. Now we have two, I believe, calls. Yeah, you see the referee, the back referee, at top of the screen, right in the middle. He puts his hand up already. And then probably something else happens. So two infractions on the same play.
And a full 2 minutes of the 5-on-3 for the Coyotes. The Kings had that situation. Couldn't score in the first. Coyotes trying to tie it up. Here's Radim Verbata. Over to Morris, right side. Morris hangs on, feeds it down into the corner. Excuse me, not Morris, Ekman-Larsson. Now back over to Radim Verbata. In deep, Verbata gets it back. Verbata shoots, blocked in front. Ekman-Larsson with it. Ekman-Larsson put it down into the corner, gets a return pass. Ekman-Larsson back in the corner, now again to him, now to Verbata. Shoots and a save and a rebound, poked into the corner by Quick. Puck comes back up the middle now to Verbata. Verbata left side, gets it back again. Verbata waits, right side shot is deflected by Quick, diving and deflected into the corner.
Quick wants to face off outside. He's saying went off the side of the net. Again, you know, you just try to get the attention of the refs, and yeah, they're going to point outside, and that's where it's going to go. So if it doesn't hit a King here, especially the goaltender, you see, take a look now. Does it hit the side, left side of the screen down low? Quick get a piece? No. It's off the side. So that's why Jonathan Quick quickly got the attention of the referee. I mean, we see these replays, and they're easy to see on a replay. It's tough on the ice. It's game speed. The puck's going almost 100 miles an hour. Does it hit something, doesn't it? The important thing, and we've seen it now quite a bit here in the first early part of the season, all four officials, two referees, two linesmen, getting together, sharing information to get it right.
This is the fourth time here early this season the Kings have been two men short. They've allowed one power play goal. That was to Chicago in the opener at Staples Center. Here's Ekman-Larsson. Gives it back to Verbata. Radim Verbata. Left side it goes. And Sullivan to Verbata. Back over to Sullivan. He had knocked it out of midair. Kings almost took it away. And the Coyotes clear it themselves. Out across the blue line. 40 seconds to go in the two-man advantage. Kings with it again. And Scuderi drives it deep into the Phoenix zone.
A little panic setting in there with the Coyotes after they missed the first opportunity. Bad pass. Puck out of the zone.
Oliver Ekman-Larsson moves it up ahead into the Kings zone. Here's Bodker on the right side. Bodker to Ekman-Larsson. Oliver Ekman-Larsson with it, right side, two-man advantage. Here's Verbata in the slot. Verbata can't get a shot. Lewis was right in front of him. Now Ekman-Larsson, Verbata, right side. Ekman-Larsson moving in. He shoots. He hit the post. Rebound, score! The Coyotes tie it up. The rebound came just off to the right side, and Michael Bodker ties the game at 1-1.
And there's going to be 10 seconds remaining on one of the penalties for the Kings. You'll see a good job of changing the angle of the shot. Watch Ekman-Larsson. Looks once, goes back, gets it again. Does he change? Does he pull and drag? Yes, he does. And much like Kopitar, Ekman-Larsson goes the other way, getting back against the flow. Now, he doesn't score, but by change, you see him change the angle about a foot there? He gets it through. And that's one thing the Kings have struggled with, getting it through. Bodker off the body, to the ice, stick on the puck, and he's right there. He'll take that one with a wide-open net. So the Kings had a holding the stick and a holding call, both on the same play. 5-on-3, we're tied 1-1.
And the Kings are back at full strength right now. But they gave up the goal that has tied the game at 1-1. Here's Derek Morris at the right point. Tried to get it to Vermette. Kings trying to pick it up. Colin Fraser in the corner for the Kings. Got it up ahead to Richards, but off his stick. Coyotes take over there. Bodker from Ekman-Larsson and Verbata. And the puck is tipped at center ice and taken now by the Coyotes again across the line. Korpikoski dropped it back. Poked out the center ice. Kings may have a chance here on a break. Down the right wing side is Richards. Richards dropped it back, but it's intercepted by the Coyotes. Back they come to center ice. Across the line, Shane Doan, his pass, tipped away, but Doan got it again. Here's Doan on the right side, and Jake Muzzin in to break it up. Muzzin gives it to Kyle Clifford. He cleared it out to center ice. 5 minutes gone by in the second period here with the game tied 1-1. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, his pass taken away by the Kings. Kings come back, pass up ahead, down the middle goes Williams. Williams in front, pass in front again, and a score by Kopitar. Nice pass by Williams to Kopitar, and the Kings lead 2-1.
Little confusion in the neutral zone. That allows the Kings to go on attack. Initial pass, Kopitar all the way to the ice to Williams. Williams realizes that Mihalik has the angle on him. We see the neutral zone here. Here it comes. Watch this pass. Big. Now, is it a breakaway? No. Mihalik, the defenseman, good stick. Drop pass right there, wide open net. And Andre Kopitar, you just got the feeling the other night, Bob. You just had the feeling in Edmonton that he was just that close. Now, here, Williams with his head up. He tries to suck everyone to the puck, and that's what he does. And you can tell right there, Williams looked over his shoulder, so he knew Kopitar was coming. Right now, they're checking to make sure the net was not off the mooring before the puck's in. Those types of things, referee points, it's going to count. Neat little play by Williams. Kopitar with a put-on.
So Kopitar with two goals for the Kings here in this game so far tonight, and the Kings with a 2-1 lead. Jake Muzzin's going to get an assist for the Kings on that goal. 5:08, the time of the goal. Now along the boards in the Kings zone. Kings try to clear, can't do it yet. To the blue line, held in. A shot saved by Quick on a bouncer. And he hangs on, and Alexander Bolduc got dumped right at the whistle.
Just want to take another look at that goal. Again, the play of Williams. He gets the pass. Now the stick of the defender forces him. See him look once over his shoulder? He doesn't have to look again. He looked initially. Once he got the puck, that's when Williams sensed and felt and found that Kopitar was going to be open. If Williams felt he could have had the chance on the breakaway, he would have taken it. But because Mihalik was there, he decides no. Good stick work by the defenseman, but a better pass by Williams.
Ready on the draw now in the Kings zone. 2-1 Kings. We're in the second period. Chipchura on the draw for the Coyotes and Stoll for the Kings. And puck taken by the Kings, and Stoll brings it up to center ice. Jared Stoll with it, feeds it on the left wing. Then a shot saved by the Barber. Stoll right in front of the puck was loose for a moment. Chipchura has it though for the Coyotes. Sent deep into the Kings zone. Chipchura going forward to the side of the net, swept away by Stoll over to King. Stoll goes by to pick it up and couldn't clear it yet. Now it comes across the line out to center ice. And the Kings have it back in their own zone. Here's Drew Doughty. Doughty up to center ice. into the zone. Doughty right side looking for room. Sent it out on the left wing, and the Kings keep it alive, though. Left wing side, picked up by Lewis. Lewis got it from Dwight King. Lewis pass in front, and Stoll couldn't get a good stick on it to get a shot. He gets knocked down in the crease. And everybody shoving down there now, right in front of the Phoenix net.
Good crash by the Kings. Simple plays a couple of times on entry. Get it wide, and then get it to the net. That's the part of the game the Kings will work on. Outnumber the other team there. Get some rebounds. Well, Kopitar ends up with a wide open net. 2-1 Kings. Okay, Andre Kopitar gets two. He was on his game the other night. Maybe it took him one game to get going. He's been playing over in Sweden. Now, if the Kings didn't get everything going, all cylinders, Mike Richards, you look at him now. Okay, can he get something creatively going? It's again, he's not a goal scorer, Mike Richards. He doesn't have the shots of the other guys, but... And again, we know what he did in the playoffs last year. We know he took control of the Vancouver series, but if you get two centermen going, then you become that much more dangerous.
And on the draw here in the Coyote zone, here is Justin Williams. He shoots, and a save and a rebound comes out the right side, and a shot there as it's held on by LaBarbera, the shot from the right wing side.
Justin Williams dangerous again on a faceoff, and it's not like it's cleanly won, but that's just being ready. Right side, he has to fight someone off, comes around. Brown takes a couple of guys to the net. That allows a little bit of room right there for Williams. That actually, after the drop of the puck, both guys kind of switch positions.
Voinov had the shot from the right side, and the Kings try to pick it up again now, and Martin Hanzel has it. He's chased from behind by Williams. Hanzel dropped it off in the Phoenix zone, and Oliver Ekman-Larsson with it. Kopitar from Brown on the first King goal. Kopitar from Williams and Muzzin on the second King goal. The Kings lead it 2-1.
Kopitar has benefited for two goals, and it takes a lot more people. The guy I'm noticing, Bob, is Justin Williams. He seems to have just that little extra step right now getting on pucks.
Coyotes, Hanzel sends it across the line. Kings take it away. Dwight King played it off the boards right side. Justin Williams goes in, pokes it down into the corner. He couldn't get to the puck soon enough to get a shot, but he kept it in the zone. Now he sends it up the middle. Here's Doughty on the right side. Shoots, and a save and a rebound. Comes back for the boards, and the Coyotes control it there. Michael Bodker, he can't clear it out yet. Dwight King held it in for Lewis. Lewis driving in. Lewis to Stoll in front. Didn't get it. Stoll driving to the net. Couldn't get the proper angle on his shot.
I think LaBarbera got a piece of that one. Hard shot, too.
Now a shot, and talk about a hard one. The blade went farther on the shot. Here's Bodker alone in front. Bodker shoots. Saved by Quick, and he had his stick or his skate along the post, and he made the save. The fans thought it went in at first.
This is hockey. This is exciting. This is end-to-end. The cross-ice pass right in the crease for the Kings. I think Stoll got a backhand on it. Lewis takes it wide. Watch how hard Stoll gets this one. Yeah, LaBarbera's there. He sensed it, and he kept the big pad there. Then you go the other way. Snap the stick. Bodker, who really skates as well as anyone. Look at him just take off here. He goes wide, watch the toe nail save right there by Jonathan Quick. Then the stick, then the extension, and the flexibility. They're taking a look at this one. Is it over? Is it over? Is it over? No, it is not. And even if it is, you can't see it. I think goaltenders now, Bob, are they know that they have overhead cameras. And on plays that are close, what they try to do is just cover anything over top of that area. If they're unsure where the puck is, just make sure the camera, at least the above camera, the high camera, will not be able to pick it up. See the stick extension there by Quick? That forced the move by Bodker, and Bodker couldn't get strength on it. And then there's a second jam at it. Stick extension, Bodker tries to make the move, stick on the skate, and it's amazing. I'm still amazed at Jonathan Quick. I shouldn't be. I see it every game. Yeah. But he's kind of going one way, but he's able to extend the other. He's a big kid. I mean, he's got big, strong muscles, yeah. Skating muscles, but he's so flexible, too.
It's got to hurt your toenail when you make a save with a toenail, though. Puck comes back to the blue line. Morris shoots, and a glove save by Quick.
Now, that one's a little easier. Face-off one, but Kings boxing out there to allow everyone to see. Now, the Kings make a quick change. Not a quick change in goal, but a quick change of forwards. Full-scale change, so just get the big boys on the ice again. Daryl Sutter. Like many coaches, you sense when a line has it going. And right now he knows Williams got it going. He knows Brown has it going. Kopitar has two. So sometimes double shift them, get them right back out there.
Remind you, fans, Kings will be home on Monday night, the Vancouver Canucks, and everybody getting a replica of the Kings Stanley Cup ring. Right after our game tonight on Hockey Night in Southern California, it's going to be the Ducks and the Nashville Predators. The Predators then will be at Staples Center next Thursday. Up to center ice, Drew Doughty. Got a new stick. Got a blade on it. Offside, go the King.
That's important. Certainly is. Coming up later on the Carl's Jr. Sports Update, do you believe in miracles?
Well, yes,
Patrick,
Al.
Yeah, I think so. Patrick O'Neill will have a little bit more about that coming up. Carl's Jr. Sports Update.
Faceoff will be outside the King blue line. Quick coming into this game, it stopped 65 of 70 shots in the last two games. He's faced 19 shots tonight. Made 18 saves. There's a penalty coming up to Shane Doan. He tripped or hooked Doughty. So the Kings get another chance to see if they can get their first power play goal of the season.
Offensive zone penalty, Drew Doughty with a quick feed. But Doughty's been on top of his game. Daryl Sutter's been talking about that. Points aren't there, but watch him. Back to the puck, watch this. One way, go. See how quick that is, and Doan was just caught saying, you know, I'm gonna get him. But by reaching out, he gets him with a stick first, and that's all. So quick feet by Drew Doughty. That's an asset that any player would like to have, and Kings man advantage.
Stoll up front with Brown and Williams for the Kings. Muzzin at the left point, and the right side is Martinez. Puck taken to center. Now what Daryl Sutter said about the point men on this power play, Jim, don't be over respectful of the veterans up front. If you have a shot, take it. He wants to see those young defensemen take the shot if they have it. Here's Stoll on the right side. Stoll shoots, save LaBarbera. He dropped it right in the crease and then covered it up.
And one of those guys, of course, Bob, is Jake Muzzin. He's out there, probably has the hardest shot of all those young defensemen. But it is a human nature. I've been there before. I remember my first game when I played with Wayne Gretzky, and I was on the wing with him. And, you know, I'd seen him play for years and years. I played against him. Yeah. But it's just a matter of you get out there, get it to Wayne. It's the same situation with young defensemen. Daryl Sutter wants to take the pressure off them. He says, don't worry about that. I'm telling you to shoot.
Now Doughty at the right point. He's out with Voinov back at the points on the power play. Here is Carter trying to get to it, but he's muscled off by Morris, who clears it up out of play, and the Kings have a minute 24 to go on this power play with a 2-1 lead on goals by Andrei Kopitar.
Yeah, Daryl Sutter was telling Drew Doughty to keep shooting. You know, a couple of games ago in Colorado, Doughty had 17 opportunities to get the shots on net. Didn't get many through, but, you know, that's just, Daryl Sutter says, keep shooting. Drew told me now he's going to start looking for sticks off to the side. If you get it, can't get it through, shoot off to the side, hope for a deflection. Tripping call coming up here against the Kings.
Wow.
A reaching call, an offensive zone call, and it will neutralize the man advantage. Mike Richards reached out. So 1:18 remaining on Doan's penalty. That'll be the 4-on-4 situation. Then the Coyotes would get the penalty. So a lot of eyes right now on Mike Richards. Loose puck. He reaches, and stick makes contact with a skate. And that's the reason for the call. Offensive zone draw, 4-on-4.
And the draw back in the King zone to the right of Jonathan Quick. Talking about power plays, Doughty needs only one power play goal to tie Matthew Schneider. Then a shot up high and wide to the right by Yandel. And the puck is taken by Kopitar. Doughty, one power play goal to tie Matthew Schneider for sixth all-time by a King defenseman. Coyotes at center ice. Verbata knocks it down there. Still 4-on-4 skating here for another 55 seconds. Coyotes come to center. Verbata couldn't get the pass. Quick out to give it to Kopitar. Kopitar sends it down into the corner, and now Hanzel in to throw a check there at Voinov. Voinov gets away from Hanzel and passes it to a safe area back behind the net. Now to center. Kings with it. Here across the line is Martinez. His pass taken away by David Schlemko. Schlemko to Yandel. Yandel at the blue line. Steps around Brown. Drives it into the King zone. Chased in by Scuderi. Scuderi over to Doughty. Doughty's pass going to be taken by Brown. Brown being chased there, and he pokes the puck out to center ice. Chased it down himself. tipped away from him to picked up by Doughty, but the Kings go offside on the play. Just couldn't get back onside. I think it was Stoll trying to get back.
That's what happened, and of course, there's a Slava Voynov. The last shift, he made a subtle little play. You have to learn in the NHL how to protect the puck. Watch this. Protect first. Shield first. Hanzo's a bigger man. Protect, then get your teammates to help you. Kings out of trouble, pressure's off. Smart little play by Voynov there. The smaller man on that play, we've seen it defensively on this trip where he uses his body well, that time with the puck, shield the puck.
Jarrett Stoll on the faceoff against Hanzel, and Stoll wins the draw for the Kings. Still 4-on-4. We're only 6 more seconds though, and then the Coyotes are gonna have a shortened power play. Here is Williams across the line. Williams cut off, and it bounces free and picked up by Hanzel. Martin Hanzel up to center. Power play on for the Coyotes. Hanzel's pass back over to Doan. Doan's pass knocked away by Williams, and Williams on his knees clears it out to center ice.
You're mentioning that name quite a bit, Bob. Justin yep. Williams. I mean, every shift he's out there, he's doing something positive.
Oliver Ekman-Larsson hit there by Williams and knocked off balance, and the Kings go in to pick up the puck. Here's Scuderi. Reversed it over to Doughty. Doughty clears it to center ice. Schlemko with it now for the Coyotes. Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Larsson out of Sweden to Bodker out of Denmark. Sends it around the right side to Doan. Doan sends it around the boards, and a puck picked up by the Kings. Doughty's stick got broken in two. Puck taken by the Kings. Here is Richards. Richards down in deep. Down in the corner, going forward there. Now Richards trying to pick it up again. He does. Mike Richards back to the blue line. Here's Slava Voynov. His shot deflected on the way in by Doan and picked up now, and the Kings' Richards holds it in again. Gives it over to Martinez with a drive wide to the left. Puck taken along the boards as Bodker tried to pick it up. Now for the point, a save by LaBarbera on the shot by Voynov.
Great shift by the Kings after killing a little bit of a penalty right there. Get back on the ice. A lot of pressure on the Coyotes.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Colin Fraser joins me right now. Other than some penalties, the team has taken a lot of shots on goal. Are you happy with the way the team's playing?
Yeah, we talked about, obviously, not scoring enough goals. So it starts with being simple and getting pucks on net. And that's what we want to do. We've done a good job so far. And maybe a little more traffic so we can't see it.
You've had some different guys on your line. What's Gagne bring to the line?
Speed. I mean, you know, he's been around the league. He knows what it takes. And he's one of the faster guys in the NHL. So it's always fun to play with a guy like that.
Guys, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Bob and Jim, back to you.
All right, Patrick, thank you very much. Colin Fraser had his first ever career playoff goal in the playoffs. So we can rebound, shot, score! Shot from the right side, and the rebound came to Jeff Carter, and the Kings have a 3-1 lead.
Because of all the power plays and half power plays and back and forth, a makeshift line gets on the ice. Jeff Carter was at center between Nolan and Gagne. Kind of a neat little mix there. And again, that's just kind of because of the way the game has gone. There's the puck being kept in. You have support by Carter in behind a pinching Muzzin. Gagne will get it to the net. Rebound, there it is. So second chance opportunities were not happening earlier for the Kings, but now they're happening. And a little bit because the Coyotes could not get the puck out. Carter right to the top of the net, his second goal of the season. It started with Jeff Carter kind of as a safety valve, helping out a pinching defenseman, turns into a goal. That line stays out there. Gagne on the left, Carter in the middle, Nolan on the right.
So the Kings with a two-goal lead now. Two goals by Kopitar, one by Jeff Carter. And the Coyotes send it up to center ice to Korpikoski. He moves it across the line and back in to get it. Martinez, can he clear? No. Right point, a shot, score from the right point. Deflected in, no goal. They're going to wave it off.
They're going to wave it off. Must be contact in the crease. It doesn't have to be a penalty if there's contact. It can be incidental. It can be just knocking the goaltender, not allowing him to play his arm. I'm just making this assumption. But the Coyotes really had it set up well. Good shot, low shot, deflection. And there is contact. Martinez is there too, and Quick looks around. Announcement made right there by Francois Serrant. And certainly draws the boos here. You'll see right there, look at Martinez. He's not pushing into. He was not pushing into. Martinez would have had to be on the right side of the player pushing him into the goaltender. Dave Tippett doesn't like it, but he was pushing the back of the player, not into the goaltender. I'm not saying the referees picked it up down on the ice. They saw the contact. We off the goal.
Here's Williams. Had it poke checked away from him. I think Dave Tippett said it's a joke, but he wasn't laughing. Picked up by Bodker in the King zone. Drops it back. A shot by Hensel. Tipped away. Verbata with it. The Coyotes trying to get that one back, but it bounces past McCulloch. Kings chase it down. Left side is Brown. Brown looking in front, tried to get it over to Kopitar, but Brown was being knocked down to the ice when he made the pass, and it didn't connect. Kings try to hold it in. Verbata with a check there on Martinez. 7.5 to go in the second period. The Kings have a 3-1 lead, and the Coyotes and their fans upset over a disallowed goal here. That came with 8:15 to go in the second period. Into the corner. Kings pick it up in the Coyote zone. Taken there along the boards to the blue line and held in by Lewis. He sent it down in deep for the Coyotes take over. Kings pinch down the right side now is taken by Voinov. Voinov in the corner. He sent it deeper into the corner again, and the Kings come over to try and even up a outnumbered situation with Stoll trying to get there, but the puck taken away and cleared to center ice, and Voinov has it for the Kings. Carter from Gagne at 11:33 was the King goal. Kings with a 3-1 lead. Puck taken now by the Coyotes in their own zone. Michael Bodker with it. Pass up ahead. Long pass to center ice. Trying to get it to Nick Johnson. Taken away by the Kings though. And here is Muzzin. Muzzin in deep with a shot and a save by LaBarbera as Muzzin sent it ahead. And Richards had the shot.
Love what Muzzin did there. Not only the interception, but then up the ice right away. Back to that goalie interference once again. Now keep in mind, the offensive player has to stay out of the way of the goaltender. He cannot create the contact. If you get a stop right here, now is Martinez, stop right there. Martinez would have to be on the right side of the player and push him into the goaltender. He may be pushing him in the back, but you see the initial contact? That contact was made before any contact of Martinez. The referees don't get the benefit of the replay, but they got it right. Contact was created by the offensive player. Good call to wash out that goal.
Yandel with a pass intercepted by Richards. Now in front. Kings can't get a good shot. Backhander went down into the corner. Still battled for there by Carter to Richards. Richards pass intercepted, and the Coyotes come back. He was trying to get it out to Muzzin at the left point. Puck thrown down deep in the Kings zone, and now along the boards, a hard check by Kyle Clifford. Clifford picks up the loose puck. He has it there. He knocked Kyle Chipchura down along the boards.
Kyle Clifford, Bob, continues to play with pace. We know about the physical. We know about his intimidation factor at times. But right now he's going to drop the glove. So, yeah. We were just talking about that.
He threw a check at Chipchura, and Chipchura kind of whacked him with a stick, and Clifford turned around, and they got into it.
You know, Chipchura is doing something here, trying to change the momentum issue. You just have a goal disallowed. You're down by two goals and try to get something going. Looked like an uppercut right there. And I think that got the attention of Kyle Clifford, but Kyle's playing with pace. It's not only the speed of his skating, it's his decision-making when he gets the puck and making it quickly and just playing at top NHL speed. Jeff Carter on the rebound. 3-1 Kings. Kings, Carter with his second goal in two games. Pinch by Muzzin. Forward has to back him up. Guess who? There it is, Jeff Carter. He was a centerman on that shift. And then Gagne gets it, and they go back. So that's what you need. Smart plays, everyone supporting each other, and ends up turning into a goal because Carter had the entire play in front of him. So
play underway again now. The puck taken by the Kings and cleared all the way down into the zone and chased in by Brown. Brown got to it. Pass it out to the right point to Doughty. He shoots. Save LaBarbera. Rebound to Doan. Doan picks it up. 5.5 minutes left to go here in this second period. And an icing call here. Gagne with his assist on the goal by Carter, his 199th career assist in the NHL.
Jake Muzzin, Bob, I talked about him a shift ago. And again, he intercepted a pass. He had good gap control. He was actually the last man on the play. But then, much like I've been talking about Kyle Clifford, Muzzin, no hesitation, going the other way right away and catching a lot of the Coyotes kind of flat-footed. So that's a little bit about confidence. He made the smart play defensively, but then right away on his horse. create some offense.
And the faceoff won here by the Coyotes, and partially fanning on his pass was Korpakoski. Now he gets it up to center ice to Antoine Vermette. Vermette's shot is wide to the left, and the rebound to Dwight King. King checked by Doan, but he got the stole. Stole up the center. Tip there, but taken away by the Coyotes. Down the left wing side, into the zone, and losing his balance down in the corner. It was Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Now it's taken away by Dwight King. King couldn't get to the blue line. Got a penalty coming up here.
Yeah, hooking's going to be the call. King, a big body, was protecting the puck, and the Coyotes kept reaching and reaching.
15, 2 minutes for hooking.
We get a little sense, Bob, right now with the Coyotes. They're a little frustrated because they can't get it going. And that's because the Kings have been so effective in this period with supporting the play and being in the right position. A lot of it is skating, a lot of it is thinking, and it starts with position. Dave Tippett's going to try to have to settle down his team because they're trying to make something out of nothing at times now because the Kings aren't giving them anything.
Well, the Kings 0-3 on the power play. They were got a two-man advantage for 2 minutes. Didn't take advantage of it. Now let's see if they can get their first of the year here tonight. The pass comes to Dowdy. Back over to Kopitar. Looking for the hat trick. He sent it down right side to Williams. Williams again into Kopitar. Kopitar down in the corner. Now along the boards to Williams. Williams shoots wide to the left, and the rebound is going to carry him all the way back to center. 4.5 to go in the second period. 3-1 Kings. Here's Kopitar. Kopitar's pass off on the right side. Driven down in deep, back behind the net. Cut off by Jason LaBarbera. He put it up on the glass and out of play up on the screen.
LaBarbera does his job right there. As a goaltender, you want to make sure you stop the puck first behind the net. Then he gets it high on the glass. If it goes out off the glass, no problem. See, he had to use his glove there. That was a tough bounce. There's the referee in behind, but even though it's an end zone faceoff, that's what you want from your goaltender. Stop that puck. That creates a little bit more control. Everyone goes to the right positions.
Martinez and Muzzin out of the points now. The power play for the Kings, and Carter's going to take the faceoff. Richards is on that line. He goes down into the corner. Gagne also. Puck comes back out toward Jake Muzzin. Muzzin gives it to Martinez. Martinez back to Richards. Richards on the right side. Hooked it down the corner. Carter's lost his helmet. Puck comes back to Muzzin, to Carter. Carter on the left side. Here's Carter with it. Put it back down in deep behind the net to Gagne. Then a shot blocked by Hansel and cleared out to center ice.
Well, penalty killers, the use of the stick, and Hansel did it there. Looked like Martinez was going to get it through then off the stick.
Now taken away again and cleared this time by the Coyotes' David Moss. Kings have 40 seconds left to go with this power play. This would be a big goal. Give them a 4-1 lead maybe at the end of this period. Puck comes up in the air off the glass, bounces down. Boyd Gordon let it go. Coyotes have it, though, and cleared all the way down the King zone and gloved there by Quick. He dropped it behind the net. Now here's Jake Muzzin. Muzzin up to center ice. 19 seconds to go on the power play. The stole. Stole's pass. Tipped away. Kings get it back again, though. Pass on the left side to Doughty. Doughty in the Coyote zone. Doughty shoots. Saved by LaBarbera, and the rebound is not cleared. Held in. Picked up by the King Stoll. Now to Lewis. Down into the corner it goes. Hard check thrown there, and the Coyotes clear it out of the penalty box is Vermette. But he just didn't get there in time. He would have had a clear breakaway if he'd have been able to get to it. So the Kings fail again on the power play. Puck comes back down into the King zone and played now by Andrei Kopitar. Over to Doughty. Doughty up to center. It's tipped to the blue line by Kopitar. He picks it up again. Kopitar trying to get around Ekman-Larsson. Larsson cuts him off. Doan picks it up and cleared it up ahead to Korpakoski. Korpakoski to Vermette. Here's Antoine Vermette. He dropped it back in the slot. A shot save off the glove of Quick. A great chance there, and the puck comes back to the blue line.
Drew Doughty without a stick.
Held in by Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Scuderi breaks it up, and the Kings clear to center. Taken by Justin Williams. Williams on the right wing. Williams gives it to Kopitar. Kopitar, Coyote zone. Kopitar on the right side, still has it. Sends it back behind the net to Brown. Brown shoveled it over to Williams. Williams back to the left wing side, but taken away by Vermette. Antoine Vermette got it up to center ice. Flipped up in the air by Doan and gloved easily by Quick. 1:45 to go here in the second period. Patrick O'Neill will talk with the guy we've been talking about a lot tonight, Justin Williams, who's having a fine game. That'll come up at the end of this period. Voinoff at center ice for the Kings. Gives it to Martinez. He sends it back behind the net. Taken there by the Coyotes and almost give it away. Bodker, he does give it away to Carter. Carter's shot knocked down and taken by Hensel. Here's Hensel to center. Sends it on the right wing side. Moving in. Shot by Verbata, and picked up now and cleared out the center. And a whistle on the play here on an offside. 1:07 to go in the second period. 3-1 Kings.
For the most part, the Kings have done a good job on Verbata tonight. That last one, it was a shot from the angle, so you'll give that up. Jonathan Quick taking his opportunity to get out there and cut down the angle. And Daryl Sutter, he's kind of liked the progression the Kings have had this season. Of course, he wants to see more wins, but of course, the first game at home against the Hawks, not what you would like. Then the Kings go on the road. Real good 40 against Colorado. Good start against Edmonton, but never building a big enough lead to go with how much you're dominating the play. Tonight, the Kings holding a two-goal lead.
You would like that if you raised the Stanley Cup banner every year.
That'd be okay. Kind of similar to last year, right, Bob? Tough scoring, you can't do anything on the power play. Well, yeah. Win the cup. That's okay.
Verbata, he was the leading scorer, leading goal scorer for the Coyotes last season. 35 goals. He's out of the Czech Republic. Here is Yandel. His shot into the chest of the King goaltender, Jonathan Quick.
And right there is another example. For the second time in a row, the Coyotes enter the zone, but the Kings handle the rush by deflecting it outside. Earlier it was Verbata. This time it's Yandel. Of course, you're down two goals. The Coyotes are going to try to get defensemen involved. Look at this. Doughty backs off, gives the outside. Look at the support through the middle, though. You have Scuderi, you have Stoll. Everyone through the middle. Look at King. So that's protect the middle of the ice. Trying to hold that lead.
Faceoff will be to the right of Quick now. And won by the Coyotes, Antoine Vermette. Back to the blue line, sent down into the corner. Verbata going forward along the boards. Verbata back to the blue line and sent down in deep where Kopitar goes for it. And King couldn't clear. Verbata with a shot off the skate. Skating right through in front was Bodker. Now taken by the Coyotes again. Left wing side, here's Michael Bodker. Sends it down in deep, taken away by Kopitar. 14 seconds to go in the period. Kopitar double teamed, but he got a nice pass off to Voinoff. Now taken there by Nolan, he drives it wide of the net. 5 seconds to go in the period. Hard check by Jordan Nolan, and the period is gonna come to an end right now. That was a hard check by Nolan on Sabinek McCulloch. And in the second period, the Kings get 3 goals, 2 by Kopitar, 1 by Carter. Bodker responds for the Coyotes. Kings lead it 3-1.
That was on cue there for Jordan Nolan, because after Patrick O'Neill talks to one of the Kings, Justin Williams, later on in the intermission, we'll take a look at Jordan Nolan's day with the cup, of course, during the summertime. But control factor by the Kings there, started by the big guns, Kopitar up front, those guys, but the Kings got more of a roll line after line after line. 3-1 Kings after 2 periods. Welcome back once again, Glendale, Arizona. So the Kings do have that 2-goal lead heading into period number 3. The Coyotes not necessarily known as an offensive team before this year, but they have scored now 16 goals on the season. And we're joined right now by Kings assistant coach, Davis Payne. First of all, Davis, welcome to our broadcast. The word I've been using tonight, Davis, is control. How have you felt about the first 2 periods?
Oh, it's been pretty solid for us, and I think that control starts right below our goal line. Our D are doing a pretty good job of being quick back there, finding our outlets, center, patrolling that middle ice. And as long as we're controlling that middle ice and making sure we're getting pucks up out of our own zone, the next play is for us to get in behind their defensemen and play deep.
All right, Davis, thank you very much. So control starts down low, middle of the ice, and Davis calls it right there. So we'll see if the Kings can keep going here in the third period, provide more of that same control with a 2-goal lead over the Coyotes.
And the third period underway as the puck taken by the Kings and cleared across the blue line by Doughty. Taken away by the Coyotes, back across the line. Polk checked away there on a shot as was sent down the right side by Bolduc and then poked away from him. Picked up by Doughty. Doughty put it behind the net. Taken away there by Korpikoski. Then a score! First shot. A score from the right side by Shane Doan. And now it's a 1-goal lead and a bad start to the third period for the Kings.
Deja vu back to Colorado, when the Kings were really in control after 40, and I probably even think more so tonight, but then behind the net, Davis Payne was just talking about that. And interception, Doughty's intercepted, doesn't work yet, but then Doan perfectly picks the far corner. So the Coyotes get the Kings moving around. And Doan just has the play in front of him. He doesn't overplay it by getting in too quickly. He waits for the puck to be there, then skates into it all in one motion. And we've got a game of it. Kings with a one goal lead.
In the first minute of play in the third, and now the Coyotes back in their own zone as Shane Doan gets the goal, and the Coyotes come back again across the line. Korpakoski was the one that got the puck to Doan. 22 seconds into the third period. Here's Martin Hanzel. Tried to come in front. He threw it in front. Broken up by Martinez. And the Kings back up to center ice. Banked off the boards and chased in by Justin Williams. Williams has four shots to lead the Kings in the game tonight. Verbata has four to lead the Phoenix Coyotes. Here's Williams again. Left side, but the puck taken away. And a penalty going to be called here.
I believe it's Justin Williams. Tripping is going to be the call, so the Coyotes get what they need, a quick goal. Now they draw a penalty. Offensive zone one against Williams, so the first 40 has been pretty solid for the Kings tonight and a couple games ago and last game, too. There it is, sticking to the skates. So that control all of a sudden turns to a little bit of, uh-oh, back within one. Big penalty kill needed here for the Kings, and that's one thing that happened many times last year. With the success of the Kings, the penalty kill actually kind of brought things back under control.
Face off in the Kings zone. And the Kings with a one goal lead. Kings win the draw, stole to Doughty, and it's cleared back down into the Coyotes zone. The Coyotes, one out of five on the power play right now as they have the man advantage here trying to tie the score. Pass on the right wing side, overskated, Kings have it. Back to center ice they come. Down the left side is Stoll, driving, Stoll in front, shoots! Deflected wide to the right side. Back to center ice. Coyotes, Doan across the line. Coyotes still control it. Check thrown there on Sullivan by Doughty, and Stoll clears it for the Kings.
Breaking it up, Scuderi first, then Doughty. Two defensemen working together. A lot of pressure to break it up.
Back into the Kings zone. Chased down into the corner now and picked up and driven along the boards, and it bounces past Ekman Larson. Chased down by Clifford. Ekman Larson back to get it and got his body in front of Clifford so that Ekman Larson could control the puck, and he has it again behind the net. Third period just underway, and the Coyotes score 22 seconds into the third period. Tipped away by Clifford at center ice, but played again and fired down and deep by Ekman Larson. Coyotes on the right side on the power play for another 45 seconds. Back behind the net. Coyotes get it back out to Morris. Morris over, a shot by Yandle and a save by Quick. Kings trying to clear, can't do it yet. Yandle holds it in, then he gets checked, and the puck forced out the center, but a penalty, I think, against the Coyotes here. No, wait. Offside called here, but...
But Jared Stoll with a speed on the outside. He tried to just draw a penalty here. Ekman Larson's back. And he just went, I'm going to lean and see if I can draw one. Ekman Larson allows him to go in. Then the other way, Drewiski takes the hit. Give me my stick back! That's the way to stop Shane Doan. He won't score like that. Stick in the skate. Doan does have one here, though, in the third to get the Coyotes back with it. One.
And Doughty now sends it all the way back in the Coyote zone with 25 seconds left to go on the power play for the Coyotes. They come back into the King zone. Martin Hanzel. Hanzel sends it around to Verbata. Radim Verbata, checked by Scuderi. Kings can't clear. Held in by Derek Morris, and now he's challenged, and the puck is kicked out the center by Kopitar, who then got knocked down.
Kopitar knew he was going to get knocked down if he used his feet to kick the puck. Well, he decided, I'll kick it, get it out. Made the right decision.
Kings are back at full strength, so they kill this penalty, and it's cleared up to center ice by Brown. Wide of the net, and Yandle touches up for the icing call against the Kings.
Solid kill by the Kings. No quality chances for the Coyotes. Nothing happening as far as a chance on goal. You have a chance to win an LA Kings Authentic Stanley Cup Championship ring, along with the Ultimate Kings Fan Experience. Visit LAKings.com/raffle for full details. Tickets are just $2 each. Proceeds benefiting the Kings Care Foundation. The winner will be announced April 25th.
authentic Stanley Cup championship ring along with the ultimate Kings fan experience.
Faceoff in the King zone once again, won by the Coyotes. And a shot knocked down in front, and a rebound was there for a moment, but bounced away to the boards on the right wing, and now Scuderi chased it down the corner. Shoveled it ahead to Williams. Williams can't clear. Puck held in by David Moss. He gets knocked down by Kopitar. Kings want to get a change here as the puck comes back into the Coyotes zone. Coyotes with it. Pass up on the right side, out of reach of David Moss. And Voinov touches up, icing call against Phoenix.
No, we'll see if that penalty kill can get the Kings back on their game, and they did an excellent job. They mentioned pressuring by defensemen, and then a couple of times the Kings actually had attacks on goal, and if anything on that last penalty kill, the Kings tired out the Coyotes defensemen because they had to defend a little bit. Then when the Coyotes had the puck, they weren't fresh, and they couldn't make plays with it.
Faceoff switches down into the Coyote zone here, and Richards on the draw. Draws it back to Carter. Back up the middle now and picked up there. Carter gets it back. Couldn't hang on to it. Taken away by the Coyotes. And back they come to center ice. Flipped wide of the net to the right side by Sullivan. And picked up now by the Kings. Sent into the corner of the Coyote zone where Carter couldn't get there in time. Yandel broke it up. Now a good check there and the puck taken by Carter. Carter pass up the middle to the blue line. Held in by Martinez. Over to Voinov. His shot blocked in front. And the Coyotes get it back to center ice to Doan. Doan flipped it up in the air, and Martinez breaks it up. Put it back into the corner, and the Kings start back out to center ice again. We're in the third period. Bob Miller along with Jim Fox, and the Kings had a 3-1 lead coming into the third. It is now 3-2. Each team has 25 shots on goal. Coyotes take their time back in their own zone now. And now come up to the blue line. Zabinek McCulloch. Gets it on the left side, driven down deep and into the corner. Going for there is Alexander Bolduc. Pass right up the middle, didn't connect at first. Now held in by McCulloch. His shot is knocked up in the air, and who's going to get it? Kings do, but it's intercepted for a moment along the boards, and now taken by Jake Muzzin. Muzzin for the Kings, over to Drewiski. Drewiski to center, feeds it left side. Jordan Nolan, he's got some room. Nolan shoots, and it's wide to the right. He got a lot of that, but he sent it wide. Puck comes up to center ice, broken up by Doughty. Doughty put it back into the Coyote zone. 14:35 to go here in the third period. Kopitar has two goals for the Kings. Carter has the other King goal. Here across the line, sent in deep down toward the left wing corner by the Coyotes, chased down by Boyd Gordon. Kings had it taken away for a moment and can't clear the blue line. Now it bounces off of King out the center ice, and Yandel chasing it down.
Good read by King to keep the pressure on Yandel. Yandel could not do anything because the blue line was right there.
Then King went for the corner, and now Lewis behind the net. Coyote zone, Lewis with it. Lewis to the blue line to Scuderi. Scuderi sends it to the right point. Shot from there, just wide to the left. And shot by Doughty and back up to center ice. Coyotes with it. Driven down into the King zone by Kyle Chipchura. Team's changing on the fly as the Kings, Drew Doughty, gets it back up on the right side to the blue line. Justin Williams with it there to Doughty to Scuderi. Scuderi's pass intercepted in the King zone. Coyotes take it away. On the right side, thrown down in deep into the corner. Was taken away by Bodker. Now Bodker shoots and a save by Quick. Bodker set up beautifully on the right side at point blank, and Quick with a big save. Coyotes back in their own zone now. Sabina McCulloch with it. He sent it off the back of the net, taken away by Williams. Up the middle, Kopitar with a hat trick and a save by LaBarbera.
Now, weird play right there. The Coyotes thought they had it, but bounced it off the back of their own net. Who's it go to? Kopitar in front. LaBarbera with a save.
Time for the Carl's Jr. Sports Update. Mike Ruzzaroni, who scored the game-winning goal for Team USA Miracle on Ice against the Soviets, is auctioning off his white number 21 jersey along with his hockey stick and other memorabilia. Ruzzaroni's jersey expected to go for $1 million. He said it was just up in his attic with other stuff. He's not doing it for the money. He's doing it for his kids and his grandson for a nest egg. Steve Kristoff, former King, is selling his gold medal, something Mike said he would never do. Hey, Jim, does this pique Bob's interest? This is big money.
Wow, yeah, Bob, he's got that in his wallet right now. $1 million bucks? Easy.
Where have I heard that before? It's not about the money.
That's right.
Puck comes to the blue line and not held in by McCulloch.
You know when they say it's not about the money.
It's about the money. Puck comes to the center ice area and McCulloch with it again. The Glendale City Council here in Arizona, they've approved a $308 million arena management deal. They've given Greg Jamieson until the 31st of this month to buy the team. Get the deal done, but time running out. The deadline's coming up, so it's going to be interesting to see what happens with the Coyotes here in Glendale, Arizona. Here is Kyle Clifford sending it deep into the Coyotes zone, broken up by LaBarbera. 12:14 to go in the third period, and the Kings with a one-goal lead now. The Coyotes have to chase it back in their own zone. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, he goes back in to get it. Came right back toward LaBarbera, and he had to make that stop as Stone picks it up, and the Coyotes give it away again. Picked up by Richards in the corner. Richards leaning down in, gets checked by Oliver Ekman-Larsson. There have been stretches of this game, Jim, where the Coyotes just don't seem to be in sync. Then a shot by Clifford is deflected wide.
I think the gaps by the Kings are excellent. And on this last shift right here, Jurisky, who's down low right now, he started it. The Coyotes had control of the puck, tried to go up the ice, but nowhere to go with it, and they're trying to force it. When they do that, Kings create the turnover.
Kyle Clifford all the way to the blue line, gets it to Jake Muzzin at the left point. He shoots, he scores off the glove of LaBarbera, and Jake Muzzin from the left point gets the shot that gives the Kings a two-goal lead again. He gets his first ever NHL goal. Jake Muzzin played only 11 games in the NHL coming into this season, and he gets goal number one in his NHL career.
It comes on a wrist shot. I mentioned earlier, he can really shoot it, maybe as hard as any Kings defenseman. This time, he's just trying to get it through with a wrist shot. Look at that, head up. So important. Does it hit anything? It certainly hits the glove of LaBarbera, Bob, as you said. Is there a screen there, too? Along with that traffic, Carter's there, a couple of defensemen. Carter took a swing at it. Don't think he got it. So the traffic, the high traffic works, and that forecheck continues for the Kings.
And now the Coyotes coming back. A shot that hit the side of the net. Battled for behind the net by Doughty. Then it came back towards Bodker. Now the Coyotes still with it again. Let's see if the Kings can hang on to this two-goal lead this time. Here's Verbata to Bodker. Bodker checked from behind. Got it to Morris at the blue line. Morris's shot goes wide. Harum's off the boards right out to the Kings. And Lewis to center ice. Trevor Lewis sends it down in deep. He goes down into the corner, and he got rocked and knocked down by Derek Morris. Morris gets up and checks him again. Here's Dwight King with the puck to Trevor Lewis. Couple of big goals in that Stanley Cup final against New Jersey, and the puck taken away now by Martin Hanzel. Hanzel gets it back to center ice. 10.5 minutes left to go in the third. Kings looking for win number one in this regular season. Puck taken away for a moment on the left side by Colin Fraser.
Then it was outside of the trapezoid, so LaBarbera couldn't play it, and that's the reason that the Kings jumped on it.
Puck flipped back into the Coyote zone. Nolan going for it. He's got Fraser with him, along with Gagne on this line.
There's the Kings breaking it up again. The gaps are perfect right now for the Kings. The Coyotes get one pass, but they don't get another one.
Colin Fraser checked along the boards by Morris. Puck in the corner. Fraser goes for it again. Gagne is there checking his man. And the puck taken by the Coyotes. David Moss, right side, used to be with Calgary. Sends it down the right side into the zone. Taken away, passed in front. Loose puck, save, rebound in the crease. And the whistle stops play. The Coyotes with a tremendous opportunity there, but couldn't score. And Jake Muzzin, the King rookie defenseman, gets his first ever NHL goal. Kyle Clifford and Drewski with the assist. Back in a moment.
Jake Muzzin gets goal number one. Now, as a veteran, here's what you do. Okay, there's the youngster, gets the goal. Okay, big celebration. Everyone comes aboard, and you get together. Look at Jared Stoll. Hey, buddy, your first one? First one, yeah. See Stoll? Now he leaves the pack. You know why? Because the veteran goes and picks up the puck, gets the souvenir. There's the linesman, gives it to Jared Stoll. Jared Stoll brings it to the bench. Big souvenir for Jake Muzzin.
Kings trying to clear it out of their own zone, but the Coyotes hold it in for a moment. Now it comes back out to center. The assist on Muzzin's goal, Kyle Clifford and Davis Drewski. Now a pass in front, knocked down there, and the Coyotes with it. So Clifford points in every game this year. Points in four straight. One goal, four assists to lead the Kings in scoring. Coyotes with it. Pass to Doan is broken up and bounced up in the air. Yandel with it, but given away there. The goal came at 8:35 of the third period. Muzzin's first in his NHL career from Clifford and Drewiski, and the Kings with a 4-2 lead. Coming down to 9 minutes left to go here in the third. Tipped up in the air and bounces into the King zone, and Muzzin gets double-teamed. The puck taken away. Coyotes with it. King zone. Back to the blue line it goes. Stone sends it left side, a shot wide off the boards, and it is not cleared. Stone trying to hold it in, flipped up in the air to the blue line. Then it comes out to center ice and taken by the Coyotes' Boyd Gordon. Sent across the line, broken up by Drewiski. Gets it back out to center ice. Coyotes chase it down across the line. Good check by Muzzin there as he came over to check Chipchura. Long pass comes into the Coyote zone. Chased down by Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Now around the left side. Kings jump on it there and hold it in. Nice play by Stoll. Put it down into the corner. Kings still with it. Coyote zone. Here is Trevor Lewis. He got checked. And the Coyotes clear to center, but the Kings back to get it. Picked up by Slava Voynov.
Right now, the Kings are finishing every single check. It's not like they're running out of the way to make a hard contact, but everyone is taking it as a part of their game to make sure they finish checks.
Back up to center ice and driven down to the King zone where Quick sends it back along the boards. And the Kings, Martinez, clears out to center ice. This is going to be an icing call against the Kings with 7:33 to go in the third.
And it comes at the end of a long shift. So again, Stoll can't change. King, Lewis, they've been out there a long time. Third period, we'll see if Daryl Sutter goes with a timeout. I'm sure he'll try to get some indication. A lot of times the players will say, what's going on here? I need some help. Trevor Lewis goes to the bench and gets a new stick. So that helps out just a little bit. The referee says, whoops, let's go, let's get back. So icing, not allowed to change. The Kings with tired players on the ice. Vermette against Stoll. Huge faceoff here.
And on the draw, picked up by the Kings as Stoll wins the draw. And the Kings get it out to center ice.
Every draw is big, but that one huge by Jared Stoll and clean. He's tired, but he wins the draw.
Coyotes get it in the neutral zone and still have it now at the King blue line. Pass off on the right wing side, taken by Moss, and his shot deflected off of Scuderi, but not out of the zone. Derek Morris with it now. Then a shot by Moss, blocked in front by Scuderi, and Scuderi with a long reach got it up the left side, and it is not cleared yet. Nolan comes by, and he muscles it out to center ice. Under 7 minutes to go now, third period. Here on the right side, Sullivan, he gives it to Moss. His shot was partially blocked by Scuderi and covered by Quick.
Again, that's the first time the Coyotes made a long cross-ice pass, but again, deflect the attack outside. We showed that replay of Stoll getting the puck for Jake Muzzin, and you know, Bob, the more we got to know Jared Stoll over the years, the more we realized he is the ultimate team player. You know, playing last year, free agency, does he care about his contract? No, he cared about the team. Team first, and I know it's a little thing, but just one of those little things that Jared Stoll thinks about to help out the younger guys.
Now it's Kopitar on this faceoff in the King zone, and he wins the draw. Coming into the game, Kopitar had won 56.8% of the faceoffs. Carter 55.6 and Stoll 52.6. A little bit about Jake Muzzin, the defenseman. Non-drafted free agent signed by the Kings in 2010. Coyotes back in the King zone. Botker down the left side, lost his balance, slid into the corner. Verbata picked it up. Radim Verbata with it now, checked by Voynov. Verbata gets free, but his pass taken away behind the net. Kings trying to clear, can't do it yet. Michael Stone holds it in. Now it comes around to Williams, Justin Williams. He got it out to center ice. And we're going to get another icing call against the Kings here as Ekman-Larsson touches up.
Well, we're going to take a look ahead next telecast. Monday, Canucks in town. CarMax will tell us. And, of course, the Canucks have that goaltending controversy, I'll call it, brewing right now. Schneider, look at his numbers. Luongo. Goals against, better for Luongo. Wins better for Schneider. That'll be a 7:30 start. But, of course, Kings Live at 7 p.m. pregame show, followed by the game on Fox Sports West.
right after our game on Hockey Night in Southern California. It'll be the Anaheim Ducks and the Nashville Predators coming up right after the end of this game. Puck taken by Kopitar in the Kings zone, and Kings having a little trouble clearing it, but Brown gets to it now, and he got hit hard by Doan. There's the first incident between those two in this game tonight, and a hard check by Doan, but Brown cleared the puck.
Yeah, it's funny how things get forgotten. You know, it's about the 2 points right now.
Shot wide to the right side by Yandel. Muzzin back in to get it.
Well, now we got Doan going at it with Mike Richards. So maybe Richards, you know, realizing that the things aren't happening offensively for him. But Doan trying to get the game turned around, and Richards jumps in. So maybe Doan trying to pick up his team, but it looks like he's going to go away for 5 minutes. Yeah. Kings lead by two. When we broke away, Mike Richards was talking with the referee. You see Richards on the left, Doan on the right, and he was asking about a slew foot. He thought a slew foot took place. The referee told him it was just a forearm contact and a throw down. So maybe the reason Mike Richards gets involved, you see Richards, he's confronting right in front of the net right now. Now they dropped the gloves, so made sure he didn't take the instigator.
Yeah.
But I think Richards thought there was a slew foot. When Richards was in the penalty box, he gave a kicking motion to the ref saying, did he slew foot him? Not the case, but didn't want to take any chances. Mike Richards stands up for Dustin Brown. 5-on-5 skating because it's 5 minutes each for fighting.
And as you mentioned, Doan is now not going to get back until 35 seconds remain in the game.
Right now, I'll take that trade.
Yeah. Puck is out at center ice, and Yandel flips it into the pink zone. And around the boards and bounces toward the slot, but chopped out of midair and out to center ice by Stoll. Coyotes back into their own zone. They get it up on the right side to Sullivan. Sullivan back into his own zone and now driven deep down behind the net where Jonathan Quick cuts it off there. Quick looking for his, obviously, first win of the year. Puck is sent along the boards, and Morris tried to hold it in, but the Kings take it away and get it back to center ice.
Second time in a row where Stoll was instrumental on the breakout.
Then a shot wide to the left side as Stoll went to the bench, and the Kings changed on the fly. The shot was by Lewis. Here is Antoine Vermette up to center ice with Verbata. Broken up at the blue line by Williams. Taken by Brown. Brown gets knocked down along the boards.
Now I get the feeling the Coyotes going out of the way to go after Dustin Brown. We talked about that way back in the open. The Coyotes still in this one with 4:25 remaining. At the same time, a two-goal deficit. So when they get the chance, now they're going a little bit out of the way to go at Dustin Brown.
And Doughty drives it high as the Kings get back on side. And now the Coyotes start back to center. Here is Verbata. His shot and a save by Quick. Rebound picked up by Hansel. Martin Hansel, his pass tipped away, though, and cleared out to center ice by Kyle Clifford. Clifford with an assist. Points in four straight games this season for Kyle Clifford. Puck comes left side now. Taken by Korpikoski. Shoots and a save off the glove of Quick. Back to the blue line. Held in there. And taken down in the corner. Pass up the middle and broken up as Johnson couldn't get a good shot. Taken by the Kings. Right side, Colin Fraser, backhander toward the net and gloved. And hanging on is Jason LaBarbera for a faceoff. 3:34 to go in the third.
Kings will take those offensive zone draws with a two-goal lead earlier. Hansel, a big guy to take control of. Watch Doughty go down. He thinks the shot's coming. He's down. He's out of control. No way. Look at that. Right back on his feet, right in the face of Hansel. That's taking away the time and space. So Doughty using the stick initially, but then very quickly down and up to break up the play.
I want to thank our statistician, Steve Potvin. It's Denny Potvin's cousin working with us tonight.
Denny Potvin!
And our stage manager, Tony Lamb. Thanks for their help here in Phoenix. Off the draw here, Kings with it. Shot saved by LaBarbera on the shot from back of the blue line by Drewiski. Into the corner and back to Muzzin at the left point. Muzzin sends it back behind the net, taken by Gagne. Over now to Jordan Nolan. To Gagne. Gagne's pass back to Nolan. Nolan on the left side. But back to the playoffs last year, the first two games that the Kings played here in Phoenix, they just controlled, dominated the games in those two games against the Coyotes.
And again, that word control comes to me, Bob, after this game. I know the Coyotes got back into it here in the third with that quick goal, but for the most part, just the sense that everyone is having an impact on the game and a lot of time spent in the offensive zone.
2:46 left to go here in the third period. Puck cleared up to Radim Verbata. Verbata sends it into the Kings zone. Quick reaches out, stops it, gives it back to Scuderi. Nice play over to Brown. Brown checked there. And in the middle, Bodker with a shot up high over the net. Bodker set up beautifully right in the slot. And the Kings get control of it and bring it back to the blue line. Pass ahead to Brown, and just off his stick and offside called against the Kings.
Well, the Kings almost had Brown breaking in right there. Kings fans, you can share in the Stanley Cup Championship excitement by ordering your very own commemorative ring from Tiffany and Company. Please visit your nearest Tiffany location or tiffany.com/LA Kings to find the exclusive LA Kings Championship commemorative ring and championship collection. So not only rings, a whole bunch of jewelry, all about the Stanley Cup.
Right after our game, we're going to take you to Anaheim, the Ducks and the Nashville Predators on Hockey Night in Southern California. Puck comes down into the Coyote zone, and Gandel back to get it. Back up to center ice, Keith Gandel. Gandel, the veteran, he shoots, it's deflected, and up out of play.
Gandel's been trying to get it going, and just one of those other things that the Kings have done, and I've mentioned it numerous times, but a lot of times games seem to develop a theme. Speed by the Coyotes, but then just deflected outside. Nothing through the middle. Davis Payne, the Kings' assistant coach, talked about that when we talked to him just at the start of this third period. Control the middle, control the game.
Faceoff now in the Kings zone once again to the right of Jonathan Quick. They're going to pull the Barbara out of the net with 2 minutes left to go, so the Coyote net is wide open.
Stoll gets the draw against Hansel. Hansel bigger and faster, but Stoll, a lot of veteran experience.
And Stoll wins the draw to Doughty. Doughty out to the left point, held in there, and driven on the left wing, or right wing side, taken away now at the point. Coyotes trying to hold it in. They've got the extra attacker on the ice. Kings looking for the empty net that will put this one away. Puck comes to the blue line, held in again, then batted out to center ice by Carter.
It took a couple whacks, but the Kings persistent right there, right at the blue line.
Here on the right side, fired down in deep by Sullivan, comes around the boards, Kings zone. Into the corner, Williams. Williams gets some help there as he picks it free, but it's taken by the Coyotes. Yandel shot blocked, and the Kings with it, up to center ice. Here is Brown for the empty net, missed it wide to the left side.
Kings missed an empty net the other night in Edmonton, Bob. Let's hope we don't get the same result.
Minute 8 left to go here in this third period. Bodker can't get around. Kopitar is looking for the hat trick tonight. Kopitar stays on the ice with Brown. Here's Sullivan. Less than a minute to go in the third. Kings lead it 4-2. Puck comes into the Kings zone. Right wing side. Picked up there and swept in by Kopitar. Kopitar into the corner to Doughty. Doughty couldn't hang on. Coyotes take it away. Come around the right wing side. A pass back to the left side. A shot from there and a save by Quick. Rebound score. Now they're going to wave this one off. The whistle blew.
It did not look like it was ever covered up. But there's no question in my mind the whistle went. But it did not look like Jonathan Quick ever had control of the puck. And it snuck in behind them. You hear the reaction of the fans here. You expect that reaction. The referee lost sight of the puck. And a lot of scrum down low. You see the referee standing right there, and it's out. Yeah, it's behind Quick. Wow, it's a quick whistle right there. The referee, of course, loses sight, but it's in behind. It's clearly free in behind the goaltender. Verbata thinks he has one. Another look from behind. You move it over. Quick. It's open. It's open. It's open. It's open. Ref thinks he has it. Not the case, but the whistle goes. You see the referee right away. Waves it off. He thought it was controlled. And a break here for the Kings.
That's the second time in this game that Phoenix has had a goal disallowed. It happened with 8:15 left in the second period. Now it happens with 39.6 seconds here in the third.
It's one of those where the referee just says to the guys, you know, guys, I didn't see the puck. I didn't know where it was. You kind of apologize. There's a lot of times when referees don't want to apologize, but in that situation, they usually do. They just say, I'm sorry, I thought the goaltender had it, but by the replays we saw clearly, Quick never did have it. It was always in behind him, in between his legs, finally comes through. We're gonna break for the Kings, big draw against Vermette this time against Jarrett Stoll.
Well, as we found out in Edmonton, it's never over till that clock hits zero. Coyotes with it again. King's zone, left side for Ballard. Shoots, save, rebound up the middle. Hilled in again. Shot by Yandel. Knocked down in front. Loose puck. Saved by Quick on the shot by Moss, and then a shot up high over the net. 20 seconds left to go. Third period. Here's Verbata. And his pass didn't connect with Yandel. It comes all the way back in the Coyote zone.
Drew Doughty, Bob, was in behind everyone on that last exchange. Looked like a wide open net. And Doughty went down. He slid on his side to make a huge save in behind. Jonathan Quick.
4 seconds to go. We're not going to have a postgame show. The Kings get their first win of the season. 4-2 over the Phoenix Coyotes, and the fans are upset because two Coyote goals were disallowed.
Well, there it is. Two-goal win for the Kings. Drew Doughty, instrumental with the puck, but he becomes a goaltender here. Shot, bounce, and Drew Doughty in the crease. He's down right there, and he makes a save right there. Coyotes can't get there. Kings win 4-2.
So for Jim Fox, this is Bob Miller. Thanks for being with us tonight on Hockey Night in Southern California. And now we are going to send you to Anaheim as the Anaheim Ducks take on the Nashville Predators. The Kings win it here in Phoenix 4-2. Right now, here's John Ahlers and Brian.